morning or afternoon, depending on your location, tuning in to hear today. And welcome to the memorial service for Nancy Walsh, this celebration of life in this place, small in this place, and large and virtual, with hope and trust that it will be safe for another celebration of her life to happen, hopefully soon, to have all of you gathered in person. I am Miriam Samuelson Roberts. I'm one of the pastors at Westwood Lutheran Church, and it has been my great honor to walk with Nancy, especially these last years, and pray with her and talk with her and see her perseverance through great pain. We gather here physically and virtually to honor her life, to grieve her death, and to remember all she was to each of you. If you are tuning in online, there is a bulletin that you can follow underneath the video link, or you can just listen in with us here. We open with a few seconds of silence and a prayer. work with the organization of the same name, and in honor of our giving spirit. The piece we just heard from Ryan is titled Patis Angelicus, or The Bread of Angels. And all who knew Nancy know that she gave others the bread of angels in everything she did. Now hear your reading. Now, when Jesus heard this, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and 2 fish, he looked up to heaven, blessed and broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. All ate and were filled, and they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. This is the word of the Lord. Our first eulogy is from Brendan Walsh, and I will be reading it as Brendan and his family join us virtually to join me today. Mom, I love you forever. Thank you for being there every day, for bringing music and compassion into our lives, for encouraging us and showing us how to keep going, no matter how hard the journey. For being a steadfast anchor while exploring the world and fulfilling our dreams. For instilling a sense of gratitude and work ethic in all that we do. Thank you for the timeless moments of magic. For thunderstorms on the screen porch. For wind chimes in the morning. For hot chocolate with extra marshmallows and rosy cheeks. For flowers in the spring. Thank you for loving us. I'm so incredibly grateful that you and Dad have come to Germany and enjoy time with my growing family, sharing calls and laughter with Sophia and William the same way you did with us. Thank you for somehow miraculously holding on for all us boys to come home and be together with you, so that I could be there for you and personally tell you all of these things. I love you forever, Brendan, with Anne Curley, Sophia, and William.
Hi, I'm Tom. First, I just want to thank everyone for all the support they've given to our family, with cards, phone calls, flowers, food, and for the nation's memory of Nancy to Westwood Church and to Community Emergency Service. Nancy and I first met in 1969 at the University of Minnesota band's bonfire near the end of Spat Camp. She was outgoing, energetic, and fun, just the opposite of me. We fell in love, and 26 months later, we were married. Together, we raised 4 boys, Brendan, Alex, I, and Jason, who have become good, intelligent men. She loved them all fiercely, and we loved her back. She taught them the values of honesty, hard work, excellence, caring for others, and love. She did. and was bringing them together. She was a good supportive friend to many. She coordinated family and school reunions, and she was a super volunteer in our kids' schools, at community kitchens, food shelves, including Lowe's and Fishes, and CES in Minneapolis. She touched the lives of many people, and they are better for it. She lives on as part of them. But our kids and I are our main beneficiaries. She was the better part of myself. There's a big hole in me that she wants to fill. And yet, I sometimes feel that she is still here with me. We used to go for walks together through the park, but on my lake, on the beach. She would always stop to pay attention to the little things. Followed by the path, lilies on the lake, shells on the beach. She still walks with me, helping me to pay attention to the little things and to other people. I am grateful that I got to love.
Because Jesus acknowledge